Now in front of the Bongeunseo Temple in Gangnam, and this is a very, very beautiful place, and I think one of the most beautiful temples in Seoul. If you imagine, here is a Buddhist temple which is a couple hundred years old, and right next to the temple are the huge modern buildings of Gangnam. This is a further example how the Koreans manage to combine old and new architecture right next to each other. Let's go in. Because of Buddha's birthday, there are many sculptures and they look very funny. Sadly, I'm not a Buddhist, so I don't know all the meaning of them. And here, the main entrance to Bongeunseo. Last year when we went here, the last time, there were many construction workings around. But now it seems to be finished. And so I can present you the Bongeunseo Temple in its full beauty. Wow, let's go in. So people who are praying here and many, many more sculptures. Also because of Buddha's birthday, there are many lanterns. I love the color of them. Everywhere where these lanterns are, the place is full of living and full of good emotions. So peaceful, and luckily we have not much wind here. Today it's such a windy day. Bombaram is it called? Also spring wind. And spring wind in Korea is very, very strong. But for some reason, Bongeunseo managed it to keep this wind out. Great, so that I can film here without huge problems. I think before we can enter, we need to have a QR code check-in. So let's do that and then enter Bongeunseo. Also here you can see the wishes of all these people who have placed the lanterns here. So let's find my phone and then turn on the neighbor check-in. And it goes like that. You go to neighbor and you have here QR code check-in. And then, yes, and you go through here. Also to measure my temperature. It seems right.
So,
and now let's go inside the temple. Wow, also here is different decorations, all hand painted. Finally, let's go to the main plaza. So let's make a prayer. Such a peaceful place. I especially love scent which is coming from these candles.
I'm going to go to the house.
So everything here is made with so much love to detail. May is of course a very special month for the Buddhists here in Korea, and so you can see many festive events today. Wonderful. So here again, these fresks. I wonder how long it does take to make one of these. Sadly, we can still see some construction work is left, but I think they are finished with the biggest part here. Also here some side temples. With no people around. You can here also make a temple stay. This is for foreigners who want to indulge once in Buddhistic culture in Seoul. They can come here and stay a couple days. And the Buddhist monks here will share their traditions with the foreigners. I think it's a good way to promote your religion like that. How many of you would like to stay here for a couple days and to find your inner middle? And now I'm going up this beautiful gaedan, this beautiful stair, and then I will show you the wonderful viewing point of the Bongeunsa Temple. A place which I wanted to go since 2018, but because it was full with trees and bushes, no one could get a look of this view. But I saw some pictures on Instagram that people this year could go there, so maybe they have removed the trees so that people can enjoy the view from there. Also some prayer stones around the way. Also the view from here already is beautiful. I have the temple stay houses and the main temple area here. Some beautiful paintings on the wall. Korea must have looked very beautiful back in the days, but there were no big cities and more just nature. If we could not get to this point here, you can see the huge Buddha, but there is still so much trees in front of it, so we could not get to this viewpoint. Right now, they are ringing the huge bells, so I hope we can reach this point before the monk is stopping to doing that. It would be great to show that to you. So, we will be fast. We nearly arrived at the place, so I hope we can catch him. It would be great to see the monk, how he proceeds with his ritual in the evening. You see, there is the building. And there it is. and the monk is performing this ritual every evening. I hope we can go near to him. Practicing that, and this bell does fill the whole temple with his sound. And again. Concentrated he is. Even his eyes are closed. He does not need to see where he is ringing the bell. Impressive. Now we will quickly go to the big Buddha and then let's go home. There's a big Buddha figure in the center of this temple, and this is definitely a highlight when you're coming here. I was really impressed the first time when I saw this huge Buddha, because in Europe we never had such big Buddhistic structures, but words are not enough to describe it. Look at it. Statues. I guess every one of them counts for someone who has died already. wonder how many meters the statue is. Also here some givings. And everything in the huge tech centers of Gangnam. What a contrast here in Seoul. I hope the camera could capture what I meant when I said that this Buddha is really huge and a must see here in this area. And I hope it gave you also some peace in your heart like it did for me to come here today. Also from here you have a beautiful view of the first part of this temple. Really an impressive view. I think it's rare to find anywhere in the world contrasts like that, like here in Bongsa Temple in Seoul. Also here you have a coffee shop where you can sit down after your prayers, and you have also a beautiful view out of Gangnam from there. Do you like to sit down here and to drink a coffee? Or a tea. I think a tea would fit really better to this place than a coffee would do. Bonhoe Dawon. Now we are finished our tour with Bongsan today, and I hope you did like it, did enjoy it, and write me in the comments what would you do here